Hey everyone, and welcome back to BMX News. This is a weekly BMX news show where I talk about everything that happened in the previous week within the world of BMX that I think you guys might care about. With that being said, normally I have top highlights from the week. Don't have that this week, so we're going to jump right on into the news. We're going to start with contest and jam news, which there is seriously a ton of stuff. I think that's because the weather is getting better in places, so jams are starting to happen. That being said, X Games and Feast went down this past weekend. The first thing that I want to talk about is Big Air at X Games Shanghai. There's a video on the X Games YouTube channel of the top three runs, with Ryan Williams getting first, Vince Byron getting second, and James Foster getting third. Now, I am curious to hear what you guys think of this result. I personally watched it, and yes, I did agree that Ryan Williams should have won based on his tricks and how well he did them. The way that Vince carried himself after his run versus the way that Ryan Williams carried himself after his run kind of made me want Vince Byron to win this one. And like I said, I definitely think that Ryan Williams should have won based on the tricks he did and how well he did them. I mean, he landed his tricks as perfectly as you can, going over a giant gap and hitting a 30-foot tall quarter pipe. But something about afterwards, I don't know. You guys are just gonna have to watch it and let me know what you think. And I know this is totally not anything to do with how they score X Games. It's just how it makes me feel about who I want to win whenever I'm watching it. So let me know what you guys think in the comments below. And you can find a link to these top three runs is the first link in the description below, as well as links to everything else that I'm going to talk about in the order that I talk about it. And while I'm thinking about it, I don't care whatsoever that Ryan Williams was originally a scooter rider, or is a scooter rider, whatever he is. I don't follow what he does. Don't care about that whatsoever. So that is not a factor in my opinion on any of this. And it shouldn't be in yours either, because it really doesn't matter what people do if they're having fun. I mean, it's not your life. He's living it how he wants to. And if you don't want to watch it, don't watch it. I'm concerned with what he puts down on the Big Air ramp in X Games and how it's judged against other people who are hitting the same thing against him in a contest. Nothing else should matter beyond that. And I guess that's kind of a good conclusion to what I was talking about, in that his celebration really doesn't matter, and all that matters is what he puts down in his run on the ramp. With that being said, I'm kind of bummed that we didn't see anyone on the podium who is doing tricks into the roll-in, because that should count for bonus points. Like, they're adding a third obstacle to this already insane event at X Games. And then after that, we also have the top three placing runs from X Games Street in Shanghai. Garrett Reynolds obviously won this one, even though he hasn't for the past couple years. I have a suspicion that he just kind of got bored of winning, took a couple years off, and then decided to come back this year. Then we had in second Felix Prangenberg with some really awesome stuff in his run. And then in third we had Chad Curley with literally a dialed perfect run. From there we've got a ton of Feast highlights. First, we've got the Dirt Finals highlights, followed by the BMX Spine Ramp Finals highlights, Justin Dowell's winning BMX Park Run, followed by Hannah Roberts' winning BMX Park Run. And then lastly, we've got Dominic, this last name, with his winning run for Feast Flatland, all of which was in Montpellier, France. After that, we've got a preview promo teaser for the 2019 Vans BMX Pro Cup Series in Germany, followed by a Dub BMX BNG Jam, which went down in Manchester, England. Then we've got the Waffle Jam 2019 highlights that went down in Cape Town, South Africa, followed by the Ite Hype Dirt Brawl 2019 highlights video. And after that, we've got the Bulldogs Jam at the CATF California training facility. So literally all across the entire world, we had jams going down and highlights videos from them, which is why I wanted to make sure that I mentioned all of them, because I think it's pretty awesome that all of these jams are going down and there's highlights videos from them for us to enjoy whenever we are. And I'm not gonna lie, I was gonna finish that sentence right before going into the videos to give it a very smooth transition, but I totally forgot what I was going to say. So let's move right on into the videos from last week. The first one is actually from the previous week, and it's Matt Ray's AZ Heat video from Shadow. If you haven't seen this video by now, you probably should go watch it because it's total insanity. The first thing that I want to say here though, because I haven't watched a video with mumble rap in it in quite a while, it was totally like jarring how absolutely f***ing terrible this music is. And obviously as someone who preaches freestyle, you can do whatever you want. You could put whatever music you want to in your video, and clearly 42,000 people watched this video, so obviously they didn't care that much or it would have no views. I can't help but wonder, does Matt Ray actually listen to this music, like this music, or think that it fits his writing? I'm just genuinely curious. And like I said previously, you can do whatever you want to with your video, put whatever music you want to put in it. I literally don't care. I just didn't enjoy the music in this one. So I put it on mute, finished watching it, and I'm here to tell you that there is some absolute insanity in this video. 5 cab, 450 cab, because it was over hip, double bar spin ender. He does a 540 double bar spin to fakie on a street setup, and just the absolute utter insanity that we're used to from seeing Matt Ray. And with that being said, I've got 2 other videos from people named Matt, and if you break it down even further, Matt C, to talk about this week. The first is Matt Copeland's year 42 video. Matt Copeland, the brand manager of Profile, is an absolute shredder on a bike as well, if you didn't know. And then after that, we've got a video from Matt Clausen called Desert Town. And that concludes the 3 Matts of videos this week. So with 3 videos in a row from dudes named Matt, you would think that the coincidence would be over for the week, but actually we've got another video from 3 dudes named Mike, and this one comes from S&M, and it's called Mike Mondays, and this is the first one in what I'm assuming is going to become a series. This features Mike Hoder, Mike Stahl, and Mike Hucker Clark. And it's actually a really awesome video because if you think about it, these 3 dudes have 3 completely different styles, and all put together with the editing of Charlie Crumlish. It's very entertaining to watch, and it's kind of a great juxtaposition of all of these different styles put together. You go from 360s both directions, back to back to back on dirt jumps from Hucker, to street gaps from Mike Stahl, and then you've got Mike Hoder doing the most insane stuff ever. So I think it's actually a really awesome series, and I'm looking forward to more of it. And that's the last video I want to talk in depth about this week, but as always, there's tons more to talk about. Actually, not as always, but this time there are tons more to talk about. The first one comes from B-Cave, and it's of John Mayo and his video called Pre-Dad Shakedown that Chris Childs put together for him. Mayo is seriously one of the best bike riders that I've ever seen before. He's one of those people that seems like he could just come up with an idea or think of a trick and then go and make it happen with ease. And he is always entertaining to watch. And this just turned into me talking in depth about it. But he's just one of those people that I look up to in riding because it seems like he can do anything that he wants to on a bike. After that, we've got Ditch Bags from Fit. This is Joe Battaglia riding ditches, followed by a video from Billy Woodfin called My Ramp, which has seriously some of the most insane technical front brake and just technical riding that we've seen in quite a while. After that, we've got Dirt Ron's Too Fast for Food section from Bone Death, followed by Chris Fox's Mental Exodus from Demolition. And finally, we've got The Way Out, a full-length video uploaded to Our BMX's YouTube channel. This is Dylan Thayer up in Michigan's creation with his brother Jamie Thayer. There's a section from Dylan J. There's a Glenn Salyers tribute section in here, and just a whole bunch of other really rad dudes on bikes. So if you want to check out a longer video this week, this is definitely one that I would recommend. So that does it for the videos from this week and brings us right on into the product section for this week. The first thing here is a 2020 complete bike preview from Sunday. They've upgraded some things. They've added some stuff from the higher tiers to the lower tiers. They've also added a 29-inch bike. So now with Sunday, you can go all the way from a 16-inch bike on the smaller end to a 29-inch bike on the larger end. After that, we've got a video from Profile celebrating 10 years of Mark Mulville's Push Stem. Mark Mulville is somebody who's pretty well known for being an amazing trail rider, but there's actually no trails clips in this video. It's all skate parks and street, and then at the end, they're showing off the new colorway for his stem, which is probably right here on the screen. After that, we've got a sneak peek at the Pedal Driven Cycles 22-inch operator frame. So the idea behind this frame is that it's a more tech-orientated 22-inch frame, which either didn't exist before or wasn't very widely available. So it's pretty cool that this is going to be coming out from Pedal Driven Cycles. And I know that there's probably a lot of people out there who are excited for it. The last product related thing that I want to talk about this week is the new Vans BMX 79 Skate High Pro model. This is their Skate High Pro model with the BMX cup and sole and all of that stuff on it. And on the side of it, as you're seeing right here, is a picture of Bob Harrow jumping through a flaming hoop on his bike, which I'm assuming is from 1979. And that's pretty cool, and that's why I wanted to feature it this week. And after that, the last thing to talk about is the interview section, which only has one thing to talk about this week, and that is an Anthony Napolitan interview on the Palaver BMX podcast, which is ran by Chris Doyle. You can watch this one, you can listen to it, it's on YouTube, it's somewhere else. I'm linking to the YouTube version below because that's where I saw it. And I did get a chance to watch this one, and it was pretty cool for me to watch it because Anthony Napolitan is from Ohio. I'm from Ohio, and they talked a lot about Ohio in here and gave some shout outs to Ohio people and just talked about a lot of things that were familiar to me. So it was really cool to listen to. And I think if you want any introduction into Anthony Napolitan more than what you know just from his X Games Big Air stuff and double front flips and the front flip onto the fence that he did, which I talked about when it happened, and you all know what I'm talking about here. They gave the whole story on that, so if you want to hear that, check it out at the link in the description below. And with that being said, that's going to do it for this week's BMX news as I refresh my page to make sure. Yep, that's it for this week's BMX news. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, let me know what your favorite story or thing to talk about from this week was. Let me know what you guys think of Ryan Williams winning X Games Big Air Gold. We'll see you next time, or actually, we'll see you tomorrow for another video. Thanks again for watching, and we'll see you then. Goodbye.